Hi, this is Demi from the iCo channel, and today we're gonna go through all the steps of how to perform a self-launch safely according to the iCo manual. Let's go!
Kite setup with the lines downwind. Pre-flight check. All the lines need to be free and untangled. Pull on the trim strap. Connect the kite leash to the safety line. Check nobody is in your zone. Keep the chicken loop in your hand. Walk downwind to put tension in the lines. Start walking upwind, as if around the edge of a compass with the kite. Always watch the kite. Focus on keeping tension in the lines at all costs. Do not touch the bar. Once the kite stands on its tip, do a final check and connect the chicken loop. Hold the bar with the upper hand and gently steer the kite up to 45. The other hand is on the chicken loop, quick release, ready to activate it. If something goes wrong while holding the chicken loop, let go the bar.
Our friend Peter from the Kitesurf Experience channel is now gonna give us more tips about what can happen in different situations by performing a self-launch.
Hello, my name is Petar from Kitesurf Experience channel. And now we will analyze some of the steps. If your lines are 22 meters long, plus when your kite stays just on the safety line, the span of your kite is from 3 meters to 5 meters, depending on the size of the kite you are using, plus your safety leash in extension is from 50 centimeters to 2 meters, depending on the size of the leash you are using, so you would need at least 30 meters downwind of you free from any obstacle. More safety zone you have, better and safer it is. It's always important to analyze where will be your launching position, and I recommend to go with your bar closer to the water or even better in the water. Before launching your kite, I advise putting your board closer to the water, more upwind of your expected launching position, to not get tangled in your lines, and to reach your board quicker and safer after launching. If you are on a sandy beach and the wind is strong, I suggest to put a bit of sand just on the side of the kite closer to your launching position. If there is no sand to put on your kite, then just be quicker in reaching your bar. Make again sure that everything looks fine with your lines and connect the safety leash on your safety line. Make sure to not start turning the kite before reaching your launching position. The kite might slide a lot, so could get damaged. When you decide to turn your kite, it's important to be around 90 degrees with your lines compared to the wind, or slightly bit more upwind if the wind is light. Always turn the kite just with holding the chicken loop, walking backwards and slowly upwind. Once the kite gets tension, make sure that everything looks fine with the lines around your bar. Sometimes can also happen that one of the lines stucks on the wingtip of the kite and starts generating power. This is why we are holding on the chicken loop. So if it's too much power, you should just let go of the chicken loop so that the kite loses all the tension. And to reach your kite, use the basic self-landing procedure, which we saw in the previous episode. If you didn't yet, make sure to check it out. And maybe give it another try if there is still no one who could help you launch. When your kite gets tension and everything looks stable, do not immediately connect the chicken loop on your harness and pull the line to launch your kite. This would make the kite slide even longer on the ground, and this could also damage your kite. So often you will have to first walk downwind, still with the chicken loop in your hand, so that the kite loses a bit of tension and gets just on the edge of your wind window. Again, make sure that everything looks fine with your lines and connect the chicken loop on your harness. And gently launch your kite. Again, I do not recommend doing it, but if you really have to do it, make sure to follow all those safe steps, especially the one of not connecting the chicken loop on your harness until everything is ready for launching. The only issue is that your kite might get a bit damaged if the launching doesn't go as planned. But to make yourself launching more efficient, here is one extra tip. Just a couple of days ago, I realized the solution if the front line stacks on the wingtip of your kite. Before the kite gets the complete tension, do 2-3 steps towards your kite. This will help to lose the tension on the upper front line, and the line should slide off the wingtip. If for some reason doesn't work, you can always let the chicken loop go and repeat the process from the beginning. Back to you, Demi.
Thank you, Peter. That's all for today. Let us know in the comment section what would you like to see in our next video and if you have any doubts about the self-launch. If you find interesting this type of content, please support us by subscribing, like and share with your friends our videos. Thank you.